Oh, hello, this is Tak Chong from Walk with Tak. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and share. In my home cooking, one of the most important things I try to achieve is to make sure that the cooking is fun. Consequently, I always try to explore, to look for something new to do. And my fast cooking system is designed to achieve this. With flavor chasing, advanced prepping, stir frying, and template-based cooking. I could not emphasize the importance as well as the significance of template-based cooking. Because with a general template, you are free to explore by making adjustment and modifications. This video is a good example how I use a basic template to pan fry some angel hair spaghetti noodles. In this video, I'm going to show you how to cook angel hair noodles in a way that you might never have imagined before. Pan fry noodles is very popular in southern part of China. It usually use egg noodles, where they will pan fry the noodles and make it crispy. However, other part of the noodles will stay soft, and this will give it an interesting, contrasting texture. And I really enjoy this texture. And for many years, I never cook it at home because I normally do not have egg noodles available. And then about 10 years ago, I visited my cousin Marge in Canada. I remember she cooked some pan-fried noodles for us for dinner. And I discovered that instead of using egg noodles, she actually used spaghetti noodles, which I never thought it would be possible. Of course, I realized that if I could pan-fry spaghetti noodles, then it would be most convenient. Because spaghetti noodles is readily available in any supermarket and they are inexpensive. So after I came back from visiting my cousin Marge in Canada, I decided I'm going to give it a try. So I cook up some angel hair spaghetti noodles and decided to pan fry it right away. Unfortunately, the end result was disastrous. The noodle immediately stuck and burned to the bottom of the wok, and it created a huge mess. At that time, I should have called my cousin Marge and asked her for advice. Since I have something going on at the time, I dropped the subject and I decided I'm going to pursue it sometime later. And then about several months later, I have an opportunity to try this again. And it is under a slightly different situation. At the time, I have some angel hair spaghetti noodles that were left over from a previous meal about 3 or 4 days ago. I was under the impression that this might actually work better for the pan frying. Because from cooking fried rice, I discovered that if I have left the cooked rice in the refrigerator longer, they did much better in the frying process. In this case, they would not stick to the bottom of the wok at all. Well, I make a wild guess, and I thought this might actually work well with the noodles as well. And it turned out that my prediction was correct, and this time when I pan-fried the angel hair spaghetti pasta noodles, they did not stick to the bottom of the wok at all. And it was quite a revelation for me, so I'm going to demonstrate that to you in this video. I'm going to cook this in my Cucina 14-inch standard steel wok. To start out with about 2 tablespoons of canola oil. I then create a non-stick cook surface on the wok using my spot seasoning method. You can take a look at this video if you are not familiar with this seasoning approach. I'm making a relatively large portion, so I'm going to use about 4 cups of angel hair spaghetti pasta noodles. I use a pair of tongs to tease up the noodles. And then I toss the noodles in the wok to make sure that all the noodles are covered with some level of oil. I cook these noodles in advance, and they have been in the refrigerator for about 48 to 72 hours. This storage period is important if you do not want the noodles to stick and burn to the bottom of the wok. At this point, I add a small amount of oil along the edge of the noodles till they can flow into the bottom of the wok. I tossed the noodles a few times and I set the heat setting to medium-low. I'm going to let the noodles to fry for about 3 to 5 minutes. I then use the tong to turn the noodles. Now this is the time of truth, whether the noodles stick to the bottom of the wok at all. And it turned out great, as you can notice that the bottom part of the noodles is nicely browned. And they were readily to be released from the bottom of the wok. And nothing sticks at all. I then broke up the noodles and then fry the other side. Again, I added a bit more oil, mainly around the edge of the noodles, so that the oil could flow to the bottom of the wok. I continue to break up the noodles, and I turn the noodles in different ways so that I can fry them as evenly as possible. I did this for another 5 to 6 minutes. Now, this seems to be labor intensive, but it's well worth the time. Pan frying these noodles takes time, and usually it will take me about somewhere between 10 to 15 minutes. Since both my wife and I love this pan fried noodles, so I don't mind spend this extra time. We don't cook this too often, usually about once every 2 weeks. However, this is a nice departure from our normal routine, which we usually eat rice with our meals. For this dish, we're going to make it more or less standalone, so I'm going to garnish it with some oyster sauce. This will be followed with some scallions. And for this meal, I have cooked 2 additional dishes, a vegetable medley with eggplant, as well as a shrimp dish with eggs and tomatoes. This pan fried noodle dish will make a nice side dish. This dish is one of our favorite noodle dish, and I strongly recommend you to give it a try. I post a new video each day to help people to learn about my fast cooking system, which include flavor chasing, advanced prepping, stir frying, and template based cooking. If you're interested to learn more as well as to adopt this cooking system, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. I will see you tomorrow.